Hello, my fellow alumni. My name is Vince Verdial. I'm the 17th Dean of the Albany Medical College. Since I have not been on the road visiting with you, I thought this may be an appropriate medium for me to exchange some information with you today. Thank you for those of you that have reached out to the college with emails and phone calls and letters inquiring about the status of the college under the coronavirus pandemic. We appreciate hearing from you. Our students and faculty welcome your notes. Life has changed for all of us in the practice of medicine and the delivery of medical education. The college was very responsive to early activities related to the Association of American Medical Colleges instructions about limiting access to our students to the COVID patients and to mass gatherings. So immediately after the coronavirus pandemic was announced in the state of New York, we essentially closed the college. We pulled all of our students off the clinical rotations, and we have all of our first and second year students learning from distance learning. So we now have our students at home learning at their own leisure, so to speak, and spending their time as adult learners gathering information as they see appropriate. As a matter of fact, 1 week before the coronavirus shutdown, we loaded up an entire curriculum in anatomy into the cloud so that students could take a virtual anatomy course all year long at their leisure. We have changed in our delivery mechanisms, and we have also changed in our expectations for our students' performance. Fortunately, our students are very familiar with asynchronous learning. We've loaded up didactic material into the cloud probably now for 10 years. So they are very familiar with accessing that type of modality, learning from that, and having then interactions with the faculty through either websites or WebEx conferences, or directly emailing faculty about questions and performance issues. So they're very comfortable with that, and they've been doing that for a long time. Every pandemic is a teaching moment. If you think about the Hong Kong flu in 1968 and 69, for those alumni that were here then, they obviously were very concerned about that pandemic. Many of us were exposed to the HIV/AIDS pandemic starting in the mid to late 70s through the 80s. So every pandemic presents many, many learning opportunities. For example, the economic impact of this pandemic was something that was completely unforeseen, as it was such a precipitous change. That's something that's very, very important. In addition, our students get to learn more about healthcare disparities and how much more adversely affected those populations are as a result of this pandemic. And finally, they are learning much more about personal protective equipment and how to manage patients that are very critically ill and have a highly contagious virus. In this era of social distancing, it becomes very challenging for our students to learn, and so we are introducing a lot of different technologies for them to learn through. For example, our Patient Safety and Clinical Competency Center now has a module where they can learn telehealth using standardized patients. So we're trying to introduce our students to different modalities of delivering healthcare than the traditional one doctor, one patient interaction. So our students, despite the fact that they weren't required to be on campus, many of them stepped up and helped us with our patients and our staff. So for example, our students offered daycare and pet sitting for our staff that were working long consecutive shifts. They acted as an in-between between the patients who were hospitalized and their visitors who are now not any longer allowed to come into the hospital. They formed a COVID-19 compassionate coalition under the supervision of the faculty to be a bridge between our inpatients and their families during the COVID pandemic. So our students stepped up in a huge way to help us. Albany Medical Center Hospital was one of the first hospitals to get FDA approval for convalescent plasma treatment for critically ill COVID-19 patients, and I think the outcome for those therapies were very favorable. In addition, we've had multiple clinical trials with remdesivir, the Gilead drug, in order to help those patients as well. So we have both promising clinical trials and some new cutting-edge trials. Governor Cuomo decided that life sciences research was an essential business in the state of New York. So our research enterprise in the college was full go all during this pandemic episode. And we have multiple investigators that are looking at vaccine materials for treating COVID-19 or in anticipating for COVID-19. In addition, there are multiple trials looking at biomarkers to determine susceptibility of patients for COVID-19. And finally, there's an opportunity for us to link the bench to the bedside, looking at the genomics of the virus and determining how it could be best treated. And that actually is going to be a funded research project with the University of Wisconsin. Spring is always a happy time at the Albany Medical College. We've obviously had a commencement activities just in May. Before that, we had our match day, all very happy opportunities. And I would be so pleased to tell you that our students, 100% of them matched, and they got their first or second choices in their match results. So very, very pleased with that outcome. In addition, spring marked the new CEO, starting with the Albany Medical Center. Dennis McKenna, a class of 1992, an alumnus of the college and also an emergency physician like myself, took over the reins April 1st and brought in new energy and new enthusiasm at a time of great crisis in the academic health sciences centers of this country. So we're very happy to start with Dennis. Commencement this year was a combination of live streaming and some video drop-ins. So we had Hike Auditorium set up for some live streaming so that they could hear from our board of directors and from the dean and from a member of the faculty. And then the students were all remote and their names were called and their pictures were flashed up on the screen. And now that video has become a commemorative video for them, and they can take that with them and celebrate their commencement with their friends and family. We have a robust graduating class. Commencement this year, we graduated 148 medical degrees, 41 received Masters of Science in Physician Assistant Studies, 12 received either a master's or doctoral degree in biomedical sciences, 6 students received a master's degree from the Alden March Bioethics Institute, and 2 received doctoral degrees from Alden March Bioethics Institute. 23 students will receive the Master's of Science degree in Nurse Anesthesiology, and 3 students at commencement were commissioned in the Armed Services. Albany Med is very fortunate to have a leadership team that works very, very well together and very cohesively. So I think our ability to respond very quickly, ramping up certain things and ramping down certain things, was almost exclusively as a result of a leadership team that's been working together for a great period of time. In addition, we had phenomenal community support. This community reached out to us in many, many ways to help us get through this period of time, with helping our staff, taking care of our staff, feeding our staff, providing masks and shields for them. And it's just been a remarkable turnout. So I think a combination of an incredibly cooperative and cohesive leadership team and a lot of community support. And much like our alumni, who have great support in their own communities for the good work they do in supporting their patients. I wanted to thank all the alumni for their outreach to the college during this pandemic and all their support in the years prior to the pandemic. Thank you. Stay safe and be well, and I hope to see you in person soon.